Psalms chapter 27, a psalm of David. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Well, it's the personal God of David, light, as in where to see, where to go. Natural light is of God, of Satan, of wickedness, is darkness. Without God there is no light, Genesis chapter 1. My salvation. Again, David goes back and forth to it's my salvation and to it's God's salvation. It's not ours, it's God's. Everything that God has done. In the Old Testament, they had a right to say my because they did things to obtain. Salvation in the Old Testament is of works, not today. Whom shall I fear? Well, we fear plenty of things. David had fear in his life. The Lord is the strength of my life, and whom shall I be afraid? And how often we forget that, and fear, anxieties, and troubles. Remember, David's a human like we are. He's a sinner. He writes one thing one day, and then the next day, doesn't follow his own writing. When the wicked, those who don't follow God, those who don't do what they're supposed to, even my enemies, so not just the wicked. David puts a clause in there, my enemies, they're against David, and my foes. A particular group of wicked people came upon me to eat up my flesh. They stumbled and fell. Now that's the Antichrist. In the tribulation period, they of a certain religious group that claim to eat a Jewish body and drink of Jewish blood are going to do it literally. As the guillotine will come back and people are beheaded, he's going to sit down and he's going to have a Jewish feast with Jewish bodies. Read the places in the Bible where it says that, you know, in the famines they ate flesh of their children. That the place in the Bible says you eat my people. You eat them up like food. That's a tribulation passage. Stumble and fell, and that's the story, that's the life story of the Antichrist. Of all he does, he's going to stumble, he's going to fall. And notice how stumbled and fell are present tense for David, even though, yeah, it's prophecy. And there are people in David's time that wanted to do just that. And they fell, and they stumbled. And David says they wanted to eat his flesh. Cannibals. Plain and simple. Bible's right. Bible. Through a host should encamp against me. A large number of people. My heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. In what? God. Though all these people come against me, though war comes to me, God is my confidence and God will get me through. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after. He wants of the Lord and he's going to seek. He's asking, seeking and knocking is what Jesus said to do before Jesus said it. That I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Now this is not Solomon's temple. This is that place of curtains. The skins of the animals. It's all outside. Except for the tabernacle itself being covered with the skins of animals. to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. David wants to go into the most holy place. He wants to see the Lord. For in the time of trouble, he, God, shall hide me in his pavilion. Now, a pavilion is a tent or a temporary movable habitation. And it's 7 times in the Bible you find a pavilion or pavilions. It's quite interesting that he uses that word pavilion. No, I'm not going to go into Hebrew. He's been talking about the temple. Now, Solomon's temple, you could not pack it up and move it. But the temple, the tabernacle in David's time, you could pack that thing up and move it. And move it all around. That's the same one that Moses had. So by pavilion, he's telling you exactly what temple or tabernacle is there. Not Solomon. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. The holy place, where no one else has ever been but the priest. He shall set me up upon a rock. The rock of the Lord Jesus Christ. Solid foundation. And now shall my head be lifted up above my enemies round about me. Well, the enemies of the Antichrist, they're going to lose their head. In other words, over all the enemies of David, David's going to be rising up over them as a ruler. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle the sacrifices of joy. Thanksgiving. So David visited the tabernacle and brought what he was to bring. I will sing. That's what the book of Psalms is. I will sing praises unto the Lord. Book of Psalms. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice. Have mercy also upon me and answer me. When thou saidest, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. So when the priest would read, or when he would read in the scriptures that God said something, David said, okay, I'm going to do that. So David wasn't just a hearer of the word, he was a doer of the word. All right, Lord, I seek thy face. Now hide not thy face far from me. Don't you dare pray like that. David said, I've done what you told me to do. Now, Lord, you do back. And a reference I got is to John 10:24. Maybe it would be a good thing for to ask God to show you his face. Because the day that we truly see the face of God will be the day that we see Jesus Christ, maybe. Then what's wrong with that? Paul said to be absent from the body, to be present with the Lord. Put not thy servant away in anger. Now David the king tells God, the king of all, the God of all, he says, I'm your servant. And when you're angry, don't put me away. Don't depart from me. Acknowledging that David has done things to make God angry. Especially the nation of Israel. Thou, God, hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. David's at a time in his life right now, he's in victory. He's like, God, don't leave me. Let's stay right here. Nothing wrong with that, but troubles and problems do arise in life. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. when my mother, I mean, when my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. The implication there is when you do right, family are not going to follow. Then God will be with you. Jesus said, "Listen, I didn't come to come with peace. I came to cause division. A father against a son against the father, and the daughter against the mother-in-law, and the mother-in-law against the daughter." When you read 2 Timothy chapter 4, outside of Luke, Paul is destitute, alone. Everybody's forsaken him. Everybody's left him. You go through his books because of being in jail. Christians left Paul. You're serving the Lord, people are going to leave you. And believe me, once you stand up and say, "Listen, I'm going to serve God," or "I'm saved," or "I'm going to do what the Bible tells me to do," you don't need to worry. You don't need to leave them. They will leave you if you live it. Now, Jesus said, "Marvel not if the world hates you." You can't change the scripture. And it's interesting. I wonder when David's parents left him. As he says it. It's a Psalm of David. Something about Jesse and Abigail, his parents. "Teach me thy way, O Lord." We have a teacher today, the Holy Spirit that dwells inside of us. "Lead me in the plain path. Because of my enemies." There are people out there who want David to do wrong. "Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in the plain path because of my enemies." And he just got finished talking about his mother and his father. David's got people out there who wants him to do wrong. Listen, his uncle, I forget his name, causes quite a bit of stir in the family, especially with Amon. And then that guy has the nerve to go up to David and say, you know, and delivers the news that Amon was killed. And then there's people that want David to do wrong. And David's praying for the way and the plain path outside of everybody trying to get him to do wrong. That's a proper prayer to pray. Especially when you got religion rampant. When religion's in the church house today, the Baptist church house. You got to pray to God for the right way. You ain't going to get it out of the pulpit. And I'll say it, when you got the Bible Baptist Church of DeLand, Florida, with Pastor James Knox, is a wonderful guy. He's a great guy. You're not going to find 3,000 churches like his in Florida. You're going to have to travel very far away before you get to a church like his. That go out there and do what they're supposed to do and learn what they're supposed to learn and do right. I believe, and I could be wrong, but I believe if you were to go visit Brother Knox's church between now and this Sunday, I bet you would not see any Christmas ornamentation inside or outside that church. I guarantee that come springtime, his children are not going to be out in the church grass looking for eggs. Now, those kind of churches that don't conform to the world and don't put up the decorations, they're far and wide. Everyone's a sinner. Everyone's done wrong. There's none righteous. But why do we gotta go in with the world's ways? As a church, why can't we sin unknowingly? Why we gotta do it on purpose? And that's what these holiday things are. They're purpose. If you really sit back and study and look at what these things are, you'll find out they're not God. God told you what holy days there were. Why don't we honor them? Deliver me not over unto the will of my enemies. What's the will of the enemies? Back what we read already, they wanted to eat them. They want to kill them. They want to destroy God out of the land. They didn't want the Jews to have the land. Sound familiar? False witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty. Well, that's the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm not saying he's not David either. There's one in the gospel says something about they sought false witness against him. It's not like many came or a lot came. Something, I forget what it is. But, I mean, they put the ad in the newspaper and people showed up in a line. And guess what it says after that? It says they couldn't get one person to agree with another person. So they showed up purposely to lie. Now, you can't say verse 10 is Jesus because Mary followed him all the way to the cross. Joseph, we don't have no idea. I have no idea. I've not been taught or not been shown no history book of what happened to Joseph. From what I've been told, it's presumed that Joseph died. I don't know. Joseph was a righteous man. But Mary stayed with Jesus all the way through. But verse 12 is the Lord Jesus Christ. 11's not. 13. I have fainted. That's falling down forward. Your body's tired. There's something wrong. Unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. He's relying on God all the way. The land of the living, that's not the graveyard. When you walk in a graveyard, most chances the people, well, you don't see the people, but when you walk in a graveyard, there's mostly the land of the dead. And the land of living should be Jerusalem. The city that has God, has the law, and has the dwelling of where God is. Wait on the Lord. Patience. Don't jump ahead. Be of good courage. And he, God, shall strengthen thy heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord, patience. The Lord's timing is always the best timing.